Hello again, everyone. You know, food safety during outdoor summer activities, it can be tricky. As the temperatures get higher and higher, it's important to remember the necessary steps we need to take to prevent foodborne illnesses. Here with us again today is Dr. Amkem Howie of Iowa Health Des Moines. Dr. Kem Howie, thank you very much for being here. What impact does warm weather have on food? How does this all happen?
Well, bacteria like warm environments, and they grow fairly quickly. Most of them do when the temperature is warm. We get focused on the fact that this can occur on dairy products, but really we see it on fresh produce as well.
Well, how can we prevent it?
Well, prevention is the key here. A couple things to keep in mind. Washing is very important, keeping things very, very clean. So remember, wash your hands, wash the cooking surfaces that you're going to cook that food on, and scrub your fruits and vegetables real clean. So wash your hands, wash your surfaces, and then also wash the food you're going to cook. And then also remember, don't leave things out too long. At 90 degrees the temperature, 2 hours is enough. But if that temperature goes above 90, an hour may be all it takes.
All right. So if something happens, what are the symptoms?
Yeah. So not very, these are symptoms that are very common in other things. But think of nausea, think of vomiting. In the context of some things we talked about, abdominal cramping, diarrhea, and fever.
Someone experiences food poisoning. How do you treat it? What should you do?
Prevention is really the key, as we outlined. And then if they do, in fact, have food poisoning, get them hydrated. Clear liquids are really important. We talk about a light diet, so a BRAT diet, B-R-A-T, bread, rice, apple, toast, sometimes we refer to that. Crackers are also very important. And then obviously if the symptoms persist, they may need to seek medical attention.
Dr. Kem Howie, as always, thank you very much for the information. Good advice this time of year, especially for more health topics. Click on the website, kcci.com.